OK， 同学们看完了这个 Faith 老师的介绍，关于 IELTS Speaking Module 的第一部分 Interview， 第二部分 Long Term Individual Long Term。好，现在我们来到第三部分 Two-way Discussion。As I said before， 就是在这个 Two-way Discussion 呢，它其实 Examiner 他问你的问题呢是接续着你在 long term 这个 individual long term 里面所回答的问题。好，那我们来看一下这个 two-way discussion 到底是什么，然后呢它会怎么样被进行呢？ First of all, you will participate in a discussion with the examiner, as I have already mentioned, and the topic will base on what you have talked in part two, but in a more general and abstract way. 好，记得老师在前面的几个那个这个录影带的讲解里面呢，已经提到了，在第二部分这个 long term individual long term 的时候呢，你会拿到一张这个小小的 cue card， 然后你要就着 cue card 用一分钟的时间来准备你的回答。好，那在你回答之后呢，就是你在做这个第二部分的这个回答的时候， the examiner won't interrupt you anyhow and anyway, okay? But in this part, in part 3, it's going to be a two-way discussion. That is, the examiner is going to have a real discussion with youasking you topics and questions based on what you have already answered in part two. 好，就是说这个考官呢，他会在这个部分，第三部分里面问你一些问题，关于第二部分已经回答过的问题，但是呢，他问你的问题的方式，还有这些问题呢，都会比第二部分还要更深入，然后还要更抽象一点。等一下我们会来看这个例子。You are expected to elaborate your ideas in greater depth. 好，老师刚刚说过了，既然考官的问题它会比较深入，那你在这边呢，一定也要就是发扬哈，就是在更深入你刚刚在第二部分回答过的这些想法，然后呢，好来跟这个考官来做应对。This part lasts for 4 to 5 minutes, 大概有4到5分钟左右。好，这边它主要的 focus 是 the ability to answer, to express and to justify opinions. 这边你要注意哦， justify opinions. 什么是 justify opinions? 就是说你提出一个意见之后，你有没有办法去用证据来 justify? 记不记得我们在第一次这个 JoinNet 的 discussion?在即时线上讨论的时候，里面有一个问题 What is critical thinking? 什么叫做 critical thinking? 好， critical thinking 就是你在讲一个想法的时候，或是你接收一个资讯的时候，你不会全然的接收，你一定会有一些想法。好，你提出你的意见，你提出你的想法之后呢， You have to learn how to justify it. 你一定要有办法支持你所说的意见，支持你所说的 ideas。不可以凭空批评或是凭空就讲述一个意见。好，你一定要有证据，你一定要举例，你一定要有办法好好的解释，用理由来说明你为什么这样子想。好，那所以这边呢，它其实第三个部分它考试的这个 focus 就是在看你有没有办法去 justify opinions and are you able to discuss and speculate about issues。 好，在这个你出国念书念研究所，或是甚至在更往前你念到博士班的时候，其实很常常常你会需要跟你的同事，你的 colleagues 哈，跟你的教授们讨论某一些 issue。 那这些 issue 呢，你不可以就是凭空的去批评他，或者是你没有准备，完全没有了解，你就是乱说，就是随便乱发表一番。好，你可以 speculate， 什么是 speculate？ 就是猜测，大胆的去这个假设。但是呢，假设之后你一定要去收集证据，收集证据，这才是做这个研究的最主要的这个精神。Okay, so here they're trying to test you whether you are able to express and justify opinions and to further discuss and speculate about issues. 好。这边有一些 tips 要给大家。好， try to rephrase the questions to begin your answer. 为什么会这样说呢？就是考官有时候 examiner 有时候在问你问题的时候， 你在第一时间你接收到这个问题，你必须要确定你有没有给这个问题有 direct answer。好，你不可以回答的问题是牛头不对马嘴的。所以呢 by rephrasing the question, you will be able to understand whether you comprehend the question in the right way. 好，就是说你把这个问题用你自己的话再说一次之后，你可以更深入，你可以更加了解是不是你自己对这个问题的理解正确，然后你再Based on 你的理解去回答这个问题。 Try to give in-depth answers by further explain and justify your opinions. 好，在这个部分呢，你的回答不可以是很肤浅的哈，就是说你在这个部分回答的时候，你要深入你的想法，把你第二部分回答的这些想法再更往深入。怎么样深入呢？更加一步解释，给一些理由，然后给一些证据，给一些日常生活的实例，给你的亲身经验，或者是你从报纸上面看来的这个报道，从学术期刊上面读到的这些报道，都可以 help you to further explain and justify your opinions. Okay? 好，use expressions to allow yourself time to think. 记不记得就是老师在前一讲好，在上一个这个讲解里面有提到，有些时候你会脑袋突然空白，或者是在表达两个 idea 的时候中间会有一个 gap。 好，在这个时候呢，你就要争取一些 buffer time， 就是你要替自己争取一些时间来整理一下你的思绪。所以呢，这种 filler language, filler expressions 这些拿来填这个空白时间的这些句子，这些用词呢就特别重要了。好，这边有一些 example 给大家，你可以说This is a good question， 或者是 Well, let me think。 好，接着说这些 filler expressions 的同时，你可以顺一下自己的思绪，然后再继续的往下回答你的问题。 好 Be clear， 这一点非常重要。 Be clear when you are finished with answering。你在回答完的时候，你一定要给你的 examiner 一个 clear signal， 就是你要告诉你的这个考官，我的问题已经回答完毕，到此为止。好，这个非常重要，不然呢，你不清不楚的，好像就是 suspend 悬在那边。好，有时候这个会影响到你的分数。好 ，this part 我刚刚说过了 ，last for 4 to 5 minutes， and it's going to be a discussion between you and the examiner。好 although you have to give complete and in-depth answers, these answers don't have to be long. 好，这一点要请同学们注意，同学不要觉得深入的回答就一定要是又臭又长的，你可以非常精简，好，你可以用很清楚很简单的语言来表达深入的想法。等一下我们会来看一些来看一个这个sample video， 然后呢同学们也可以借着这个看 sample video 的机会，我们来做一些练习，最后老师会给一些讲解。好let's have a look at some troubleshooting language。 好，Some useful phrases here to help you summarize your answer. 刚刚老师说过了，在你回答的时候，这个部分到了终结的时候，你一定要给你的 examiner 一个很清楚的讯号，说我的问题回答完毕了。好，怎么说呢？我们现在来跟同学们分享一下这些有用的这些 phrases. OK, how do you mark the end of a sentence? 同学们现在想想看，通常你讲完的时候在英文里面，你回答完说完一个 report 一个 presentation 的时候，通常你怎么讲？你会说 that's the end， 或者是 that's all。 好但是你如果在考 IELTS 的时候，我们说过了，其实在这个机会呢，是你展现你的口语能力，展现你的词汇量的时候。 So there are some useful phrases you can use to explicitly show how you have finished answering the question。 好，接下来老师要跟大家分享有哪一些好的句子，有效的句子可以清楚明了的告诉考官说我已经回答完我的问题了哈。好，还有一点要说的是 You can use one of the summary sentences to inform the examiner that you have finished. Avoid saying 就是说 有一些有效的句子是可以被使用的，而不是说好像你一旦讲完了就挂在那边，然后就就是不知道该说什么哈。And 如果你出现这个情况，你在那边迟疑不决，好像意犹未尽，欲言又止的话， The examiner will then expect you want to continue or you're going to continue. 你的考官会以为你还没有说完，那这个状况其实是有一点对你的这个分数有伤害的，因为呢，考官以为你还没说完，但事实呢，你已经说完了。好，这不是一个很好的状况，所以请同学们要避免。怎么样避免？现在我们就来看一下有哪一些 useful phrases可以帮助你去 summarize your answer. 好，你说，你可以说 I think that's all. OK, 很清楚，很明了，我想我讲完了。好， That's all I can think of for now. 这些都是我目前为止可以想到的。 That's all I can think of for now. I think that answers the question. 好，我想以上呢就回答了您的问题。 I think that answers the question. So my answer to the question is...好，这我想这个就是我的对这个问题的答案。And I suppose that I've completed my answer. 好，这个也是一个非常好的这个怎么说，一个终结你的答案的这个说法。And I suppose that I've completed my answer. 好，你也可以说 My personal conclusion will be. 好，你可以变换一下说法，不一定要常常说I think that's all. I think that's the answer. 你可以说我个人的这个结论 My personal conclusion will be. 好，然后你就说 blah blah blah. 我个人的结论是，好，把你的 conclusion 说完之后，考官就很清楚的知道你已经结束了。好，在我们看第三段的 sample video 之前呢，老师要先说明我们的 exercise 是什么。接下来呢，同学们会看到一段 sample video， 一样是我们前面的这个受试者叫做 Mariana， 她呢要回答这个 IELTS 口说部分的第三个部分。同学们在这边，你的 task， 你的工作就是你必须要去这个 observe， 去观察这个 Mariana 她怎么样回答 the way the candidate answered the questions， 好，她怎么样回答这所有的问题。然后呢，一样，我们是两人一组。好 ，work with your partner to give some comments to the candidate。好，你要跟你的这个 partner 一起来观察这个 Mariana 她怎么样回答口说部分的第三部分。好，第三个这个叫做 two-way discussion 这个部分。好，有哪一些细项要观察呢 ？OK， here are four parts, four aspects that you have to observe.Number one, did she directly answer the questions? 好，你要看看这个受试的人，他有没有直接的回答到问题。好，有时候同学们要了解哦，很多考 IELTS 的人，这个同学他没有，就是他没有办法直接回答到问题。好，这个是绝对会让你失掉分数的。所以等一下，同学们观察一下 Mariana 这个 candidate。Did she directly answer the questions? This is number one. Number two, how's her pronunciation? 大家观察一下 Mariana 她的发音如何。好，她是一个 Portugal， 她是那个从那个 Portugal 来的，是一个葡萄牙人。好，去听看她的发音如何。好，number three, did she use simple language? 好，她的这个这个她用的字用的句型是简单的还是复杂的呢？好，他有没有好好的回答到问题呢？最后 number four， 请你去观察他的 grammar and word use， 你去看看，去仔细的听他有没有犯文法上的错误，还是说他文法用的都很正确。好，那他用了哪些字呢？你觉得他用的这些字是不是有效的字？有没有办法 demonstrate her vocabulary skills？有没有办法这个展现他是一个有充分词汇量的这个考生。好好，这是四个同学们要观察的面向， both positive and negative points you have to include in your presentation。 之后呢，请你们就是互相分享。好，然后助教帮忙同学就是帮忙大家分享这个经验，分享你们讨论的结果。好， Face 老师刚刚要说的是，你在讨论的时候正负 正负面的观察，请你都要涵盖在里面。好，接下来呢，我们就来看一下这个 sample video， 好，是关于这个 Mariana 她第三个部分她的考试的表现，我们来看一下。
Talking about a situation when someone you didn't know helped you, and I'd like to discuss with you one or two more general questions related to this. Let's consider first of all children helping others. What kinds of things can children do to help in the home?
In the home, I think children can help with the homework, like setting up the table, doing their beds, helping their parents to have the house tidied, and do their homeworks, that is their duties when we are young, that's our duty. And help each other if they have brothers to take care of the little ones. The elders take care of the little ones, and I think.
How can children best learn to be helpful to others?
I think that must come from the parents and from the schools. I think parents should motivate them or encourage them.To help their brothers, to help at home and at school, they schools should encourage them to help the other children that need more than them, like the poor children, and know about the different opportunities that unfortunately we have today.
What ways can schools encourage children to help the community?
In Portugal, they do a lot of this, like doing manual things. The children do manual things, and they try to sell to their parents, their family at home, to collect some money to give to the poor. Like my brother and their friends, they made necklaces and little things, and they sell in the beach to.Parents, and then they collect the money and buy a chair, a hill chair for children for an hospital, collecting the capsules from the bottles. In Portugal, if we collect the caps, they can be changed or helped to buy a new chair also.
Let's think about working for other people without payment.What types of voluntary work are most popular in Portugal?
I think the most popular are helping elderly people in the centers of elder people and in the social neighbors help with the activities to the youngest, like dancing or even teaching, helping doing their homeworks.I think those are the most common. And bank collecting food in the supermarkets. We do that a lot.
And do all age groups take part in voluntary work?
Yes, maybe since 16, I think, we have to have 16 to start doing voluntary work.
And how can individuals benefit from doing voluntary work?
By being part of, know what is being part of a society and relate to others, and to know to help the, and at the same time help them, the who needs our help.
And what ways can voluntary work improve life for the community?
Helping the community to get along and to fight for the same cause.
Thank you very much. That's the end of the speaking test.
Okay. Thank you. Nice to meet you.
好。这个 speaking test 到这边结束。好，我们来继续看一下， 就是这个 comments。 好，现在呢要请助教把这个老师的讲解 video 的这个讲解呢稍微 pause 稍微暂停一下，让同学们两个为一组来讨论。好，讨论的这个问题呢就是刚刚 Face 老师说过的，你去依照你的观察好来回答这些问题。 Did Mariana directly answer the questions? How was her pronunciation? Did she use simple language? And what's the grammar and word use? Okay? 好，讨论完之后呢请助教再次这个启动这个我们的录影，好，我们的这个播放，然后呢让 Face 老师来跟大家分享一下，就是这个考官给他的 comments 是什么。好，那现在请同学们开始讨论。